loved watching Jean Kittson on the telly. She's one of our leading Aussie comedians and writers, famous for classic roles like this one as Candida.
Oh, hysterical. Absolutely hysterical.
But her other big gig right now is helping Australians fight the eyesight disease macular degeneration. Her mother, Elaine, is facing the loss of her eyesight, but with her own sense of humour. Let's hear from Elaine now.
We were at a club and I thought it was time to go home, and I went along and this gentleman was sitting there and he had a bald head like my husband, and I tapped him on the head and I said, are you ready to come home? He said, well, I would consider it if I didn't have my wife sitting next to me.
Lane Kittson, as you can see, he's in very good spirits, but macular degeneration can be really confronting and frightening, and it can be like this, a black spot in the middle of vision that can grow and lead to total blindness. For more on this, Jean joins us now. Welcome back to the show.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you. Great to be here. Thank you.
First of all, your mum is absolutely gorgeous.
She's gorgeous, isn't
she?
She's 93 now, and she has lost her sight totally, and she hasn't been able to drive for 30 years, so it came on quite early with mum, and which it does. That's why it's really important for people to get their macula checked, because over the age, between the ages of 50 and 64, one in seven Australians will get macular disease, and it's a leading cause of severe vision loss and blindness in Australia.
Is it genetic? Wow. Does it mean that you then have a higher risk of developing this?
Yeah, it can be genetic. So my risk is 50% that I will get it. It goes way back. I mean, we've got records of my great-great-great-grandfather on the Second Fleet with macular disease, going blind. They didn't know what it was then.
Okay.
So I'm much more at risk, so are my children. But back then, you would lose your family, you'd lose your work, you'd lose your house, you'd lose everything, and you'd be relying on charity. But now, because of foundations like the Macular Disease Foundation and all the research they're doing and awareness, there are a lot of things we can do to help us with our eyesight and to help our eye health. And one of them is getting an eye check with your optometrist. Please get your, every time you go, like at least once a year, get your macula checked. Because if you catch it early, there are things you can do about it. I think we just get used to losing our sight, you know, and wearing glasses, and we think, oh, this is just a natural part of old age. But actually, the disease is different.
Right.
And you can treat it if you catch it early, so, and it is degenerative.
So, Jean, we know that like, you talked about genetics there, but there's also things that you can do, for example, with your diet, about what you eat.
Yes.
How does that work?
It's such a shame, isn't it? Green leafy vegetables. I know. And fish, and cutting down on animal fats, and not smoking, and exercising, and keeping your weight down. All the things that help all our general health, but particularly eye health, with green vegetables and...
And carrots.
Carrots.
Have you ever seen a bunny rabbit wearing glasses?
Never. No. Sarah, you're so... We'll
My
put that on the... Actually, there's something called lutein, which is in yellow vegetables, that is really important for the back of your eye, for your retina and your macula. So yellow vegetables have this lutein, which is, you know, we're finding so much out about what food
but
has.
Isn't it just for your general health, really, just all your vegetables and all your fruits?
Yeah.
Just
fresh
food. And break out every now and then.
Fish, lots of fish. Yeah. Break out for that chocolate.
Oh, yes, please. So you've said that awareness is so very important, and our very own Ita is a patron of the organisation that you're representing.
Yes, that's right, she is. And she had a story in the Good Weekend only a week ago about her and her uncle, Jared. And that was a really great story. And what I took away from that story was not only the courage of people who are losing their eyesight, but the fact that if you have any doubts, to get a second opinion. That's what she helped her uncle do, is Ita helped her uncle get a second opinion. And that's really important too. But also to get your eyes checked. There's been research that the Macular Disease Foundation's put out recently. People between the ages of 50 and 64, 70% are looking after aging parents and grandchildren or children. So they're that sandwich generation.
Yeah, they're stuck in the middle.
They're stuck in the middle and they're prioritising the health of everyone around
except
them.
Except themselves, yeah.
So 6% are getting their eyes checked. And most people would rather lose a limb than their eyesight.
So tell us, I know that there are, there are injections that could slow it down? Yeah. Tell us about that.
Well, there's without getting too, like, technical. There are two forms, major forms of macular disease. One's called wet macular degeneration and one's called dry.
Right.
At the moment, dry macular degeneration hasn't got any treatment, but the wet macular degeneration is injections in the eye, and they sound terrible, don't they? I know. But if it's saving your sight. I've seen my mum get her injections, and it not only can save your sight, it can actually reverse the effects of the vision loss. Mm. It's so important you get treated and you take advantage of this treatment. Mm. It really is important.
Science is amazing.
The other thing is most optometrists now will bulk bill. So it's not going to cost you anything. So if you go to a bulk billed place and all of them have got this second, they don't just test your eyes now. What have they got? That other thing that you put your chin in.
Yes,
that's right.
That thing that you put your chin in.
I think that's the technical name.
Your chin in, which is what I've done just recently, and I've got to go a little bit further. So if I hadn't have done that, it might have been 1 in 7.
So you'll get a follow-up, really?
Yes.
Really,
it's already
good for you.
Yeah.
Good for you. Well, I wish you luck.
Thank you.
And it's good that they just take this photo and the back of your macula, I think we just saw it, looks like Mars.
Yes, it's quite amazing. And you can get some free information kits at the Macular Disease Foundation Australia by calling 1-800-111-709, or you can go to their website, mdfoundation.com.au. Jean Kittson, thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you so much for having me.